Hi, I'm Nirja Singh. I bring you 30 insights into the art of surviving, thriving through, and not dying of a generation gap. And these are for all boomers, right through all zoomers. Insight 10. I couldn't seem to find my passion. I'm not sure if this is my passion. I'm going to quit because I feel like I've stopped learning here. I'm still young, so I can afford to make mistakes now, right? I don't know what my purpose is. I'm afraid I'll never be able to make it. The millennials' view on the job market differs starkly from mom, dad, grandma, and grandpa. Here is how it goes. Boomer, my paycheck. Zoomer, my purpose. Boomer, my satisfaction. Zoomer, my development. Boomer, my boss. Zoomer, my coach. Boomer, my annual review. Zoomer, my ongoing conversation. Boomer, my weakness. Zoomer, my strengths. Boomer, my job. Zoomer, my life. Boomer, government, military, public sector jobs. Zoomer, own business. Now think Nelson Mandela, Mother Teresa, and Mahatma Gandhi. Did they organize their lives around self-fulfillment and bucket lists? They did what they felt they had to do. Now think the Indian Idol reality show. Should we really all follow our passions? If you were to hear some motivational speakers out there, it's as though you will die if you don't find your passion. There is a perception that when passion comes, the heavens will open up and one would wake up each morning with birds singing and glitter coming out of the mouth, that work will not feel like work. Because work that feels like work is only for the losers, duh. Well, I have bad news. Most people don't really find their passion. And boomers, in case you are wondering what this passion is, it's a state of total immersion in a task that is challenging yet closely matched to one's abilities. It's what people sometimes call being in the zone, in the flow. A lack of passion for millennials can quickly lead to burnout. They find it difficult to sustain peak performance if they don't love what they do. While baby boomers and Gen X live to work, millennials work to live. The millennial generation is now the largest and also the most disruptive. Even though they are highly intelligent, idealistic, diverse, and ambitious, they also come across as distracted, entitled, disengaged, lazy, and hard to manage. Many of them hate their jobs. According to a 2016 Gallup poll, 71% of them aren't engaged at work, meaning only about 3 in 10 are emotionally and behaviorally connected to their job and company. Another 16% of millennials are actively disengaged, meaning they are more or less out to do damage to their company. And at least 60% are open to new job opportunities. They have an unrealistically high expectation of what their day-to-day work lives should be like. They want career advancement in months versus years. There is a social media overload that distorts reality, and employees are not providing them with compelling reasons to stick around. This is a challenging time for corporate leadership, infrastructure, and work culture. We are at a stage where company leaders are typically baby boomers on the cusp of retirement. They may be ill-prepared to learn and adopt rapidly changing technology used by their younger workforce. How then can companies ensure success with a generation of workers that is like no other to date? Retention strategies matter as much today as attraction strategies. A disconnected distant management with shaky lines of communication to their staff will not be able to see the issues as quickly or may miss the issues altogether. A true generational gap, if ever there was one. The way millennials like to work is vastly different from years past. Agile stories, scrums, hackathons, accelerated group learning, leveraging small, nimble teams powered by collaborative technology, high accountability, and a culture of appreciation and recognition. For the millennial, it's quite simple. Purpose, passion, and praise. So what's your opinion on doing what you love versus doing what pays well? But why do we have to choose? This Zuma Boomer is ready to listen. Book me to speak at neerjasingh.com and watch out for Insight 11.